So my turn to give you my take on Me Beyond.
Oops.
I truly believe that everyone is unique. Every one of you is unique. You're unique in your strength, and you're unique in your weaknesses. What makes successful people really successful is not only how they manage their strengths, how they leverage opportunity. It's actually how they handle their weaknesses, how they manage difficulties. So I'll give you three difficulties from my life, starting from my 20s. So we're back in 92, the time where there is snail mail and landline. I'm a young student in a business school, and in the summer, it's really warm in Paris, and I'm very excited because I'm preparing for my mission trip. In a few days, I'm going to go to India. But somehow, God knows why, I've got this urge, this really strong feeling that I should check on my family. They're all on our beach house in the seaside, enjoying the nice beaches of France. So I find a phone, dial up, and connect with my grandmother. So she takes up the phone, but she's got this very weird voice. "So, you don't know," she says. "Your father went sailing this morning, and he's been reported missing all day. We just found his body on the rocks. He drowned and died." I was devastated. I lost my stronger supporter, the person who always was by my side, cheering and comforting. As a believer, I ran to the nearby church, and I kneeled and wept. And a priest came to me, and because it was a summer, he wanted to comfort me and said, "Have you failed your exams?" And I looked around and said, "I've never failed any exam in my life." And through the years of grieving afterwards, this sentence sticked with me. This man revealed to me that in the midst of my sorrow and difficulties, I still had something, some strengths I could hang on. Sometimes life sucks. Life sucks big time. It's like a game of poker, and you're dealt with a card, this card of loss that you wish you would have never had. You can be angry. I was really angry when my father was taken away from me. But anger will only get you bitter, not better. So my first life lesson is don't let anger or loss drive your life. Focus on gratitude and what you have. But sometimes it's just not that life sucks, it's that you suck at life. And I did. I give you an example from my 30s. So I'm a freshly appointed manager. I have a team. I'm so excited and committed to be a great leader. The problem is that in that team, I've got, we'll call him Michel. And Michel is a serious pain. Michel is using every single opportunity to detract me, to criticize me. He even sent an email to my whole team saying how bad my strategy is, and very harsh word. I know it because he copied me. He recalled the email, but you know that when you recall the email, you only, you know, make it more important. So I know, but I don't do anything about it because I find it's childish. I'm above this kindergarten attitude. So of course, things get worse to a point that I cannot really bear it anymore. So I demand to talk to Michel. "Michel, I need to talk to you. I need to talk to you too. I go first. I resign." Huh, he resigns. I'm relieved. But do you think the problem was solved? Of course not. He still had a 3 months notice period. So a week later, I call him to Michel and say, "Michel, this is enough. I know all what you have done. Now it's over, or you take your stuff and you leave right now." And what happened? The same day, amazing transformation. So that's my second life lesson. If you behave like a doormat, people will step on you. You have to set your boundaries firmly and timely. So you see, difficulties are very often linked to relationship. And even in my late 40s, I still learn about relationships. So after healing from a divorce, I decided to date again. And I'm connected to this great guy. Blue-gray eyes, really great smile. You know, smart, taking risk. I really like him. And he's also sending me some kind of cheeky messages, so I think he finds me attractive. So I was traveling for work, so he checks on me every day. Sounds really promising. So we plan a first dinner, and he cancels because he's sick. But he's very excited about the drinks we're going to go for, and he cancels because he's tired. And then he said, yeah, but we'll have dinner, and then he goes on holiday. I'm really frustrated. All my friends are saying, let go, you know, he's not the right guy for you. But I cannot let go. You know, I feel like I should give him all sorts of excuses. Till someone shares these nice videos from Sex in the City. Yes, you learn from everything. And the title of the video is, he is just not that into you. He was just not that into me. And ignoring clear signals or emphasizing positive one can happen in dating, but it can also happen at work. And in the end, it's going to leave you empty-handed. It happened to me. You know, at Zalando, I had really a good job, and I really wanted to get to the board level. I had really positive signals. Every time there was an all-hand management meeting, I would be invited to talk about my project. Ah, that's great. But also, you know, in some reorganization, I was offered, maybe I could take a smaller role so they could give me my role with someone else's roles together and get someone higher position on top of me. That was not so positive. So at some point, I had to confront reality, and I decided to resign. A year and a half after, I'm not on that board, no, but I've got five others. So the life lesson here, yeah, thank you. Is don't waste your time making excuses for a dead-end relationship, whether private or personal. Face your reality of the signals you actually get and act on it. So sometimes life sucks. Sometimes you suck at life. Sometimes you pretend to yourself that everything is okay, but if we are honest, life sucks. But the good news is that you can act on it. I truly believe that every one of you is unique. Whatever happened to you, whatever you have messed up, is part of your story. And from this story, you will rise and shine. So embrace all the cards that life has dealt you with, all of them. Because those magic those cards are forming a magic hand. And this magic hand, your unique magic hand, is your key to success, your key to grow beyond. Thank you.